Praise the Lord. Ratchet Knucklehead here, a.k.a. Brother Jr. Brother and sister, we turn our Bibles to Deuteronomy chapter 33. We'll be looking at verse 12, and it reads, "And of Benjamin he said, the beloved of the Lord shall dwell in safety by him, and the Lord shall cover him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, to the admission, to the application, to the distribution of this great word, taken from the greatest book that man could ever possess. I'm a brother, this is God's word. We give God all the honor, all the glory, all the praise in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, in Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 1, it reads, "And this is the blessing wherewith Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death." And so Moses, this great man of God, is going to bless the people of God with a blessing, with grace. And he blesses individual tribes and blesses them with grace. And then he goes and speaks to a particular tribe, but it's a general consensus. And in verse 12, it records where Moses speaks and says this, "And of Benjamin, he said, the beloved of the Lord." This is the beloved of the Lord, the capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, the covenant-keeping God who keeps his covenant because he loves his people. "The beloved of the Lord shall dwell in the safety by him, and the Lord," the capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, the covenant keeping God who's got a covenant that he's going to keep because he loves his people, "shall cover him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders." And so Moses is blessing, gracing the people with this insight, this idea, this concept, this revelation, and this reality that they're the beloved of the Lord, and they will dwell in safety by the Lord, and the Lord shall cover him, the beloved of the Lord, all the day long. All the day long. It includes everything and excludes nothing. And watch this. "And he shall dwell between his shoulders." You know, in Psalm chapter 91, the psalmist writes it this way in verse 1. "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High and abide in the shadow of the Almighty." And so it hearkens that vision, that illustration. And so we see, and he says, he shall dwell between his shoulders. You know, in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, the prophet Isaiah, a prophet of the gospel of grace, he says it this way in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. He says, "For unto you a child is born, and unto you a son is given, and on his shoulders the government shall be laid on him." That speaks of the strength of the shoulders that could bear the weight of all the affairs of the world. And so when Moses talks about and blessing the people of God, gracing them, he said, the beloved of the Lord shall dwell in the safety by him, and the Lord shall cover him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders, these strong shoulders that could bear the weight of the affairs, the avenues, the aspects, the area, the arena of the world. And why? It's because they're the beloved of the Lord. And the Lord loves his people, bearing and has safety when the beloved of the Lord, the believer of the Lord, is in the shoulders of of the Lord. Now, in Luke chapter 15, we see our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ give a parable. He gave three parables, but if we look in Luke chapter 15, praise the Lord! Luke chapter 15, where our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ gives a parable. And in Luke chapter 15, verse 3, it reads this, "And he," this is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, "spake this parable unto them." And he's saying, "What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he lose one of them, doth not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after that which is lost. And so the Lord is speaking about this shepherd who lost one sheep, and he has the 99 that are there, and he goes after that lost sheep, the shepherd. He says this, verse 5, until he find it. And when he have found it, he lay it on his shoulders. The shoulders that could carry the weight of the world. The shoulders that Moses spoke, that you found safety in between his shoulders. The beloved of the Lord, he'll carry you all the day long. And Jesus says, and when he had found it, he lay on his shoulders, rejoicing. When you're the beloved of the Lord, and the Lord, Jesus, talking about this shepherd, and this shepherd is pointing to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that Jesus Christ is talking about, lay on his shoulders. And watch that. When lay on the shoulders, rejoicing. And then watch this, verse 6. And when he cometh home, he calleth together his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost. And so it brings pleasure when our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ finds us. It brings pleasure when Jesus Christ forgives us of our sins. It gives pleasure for Jesus when we're on his shoulders. And he rejoices because we're the beloved of the Lord. He loves us and we'll dwell in safety. We will be in a safe place when we're in the shoulder of the Lord. We're away from the influences of Satan, and the lies of Satan, because we're on the shoulders of the Lord. And what's the Lord doing? He's rejoicing. Because we're in the safety of the Lord on his shoulders. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance to you. May the Lord give you his peace. And I commend you all to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up an inheritance to those who are sanctified in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And unto him that is able to keep you from falling, present you faultless in the presence of his glory, both glory, majesty, dominion, power, both now and forevermore. Praise the Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, the year is 2021. 2021 believer. In Galatians chapter 2, verse 20, verse 21, the Apostle Paul, a preacher of the gospel of grace, says, for I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. And the life that I live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. And I do not frustrate the grace of God. Hey! For if righteousness came by the law, then Christ died in vain. And so Christ did not die in vain. Because why? Because he puts us, we're the beloved of the Lord, we're the believer of the Lord. He puts us on our shoulders, and what's he doing? He's rejoicing. Praise the Lord. Oh man, I gotta do it. I gotta do a praise the Lord dance. I gotta do a praise the Lord dance. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Agape love.